Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org. This is my second video about Hibernate Envers. In the previous one, I showed you how to add Envers to your project, let it document all changes of your audited entities, and perform basic queries to retrieve data from your log. You can find a link to it in the video description. The first video showed you everything you need to get started with Hibernate Envers. But if you want to use it in a real project, you will quickly recognize that you need more advanced query capabilities. Envers provides you with a powerful query API that allows you to define these kind of queries easily. I show you how to do that in this video. Hibernate Envers creates a new revision for each transaction that creates, updates, or deletes an audited entity, and stores it in the database. That adds a second dimension to your data structure, as you can see in the graphic. You can use two different perspectives when you look at your audit log. The vertical perspective looks at an entity instance and shows you in which revisions it was created, edited, or deleted. The horizontal perspective looks at a revision and shows you the information stored in your database at that point in time. With Hibernate Envers, you can use both perspectives to look at your audit information. You just need to tell Envers which perspective you want to use when you define your query. As soon as you've done that, you can use the API to define your query. Let's take a look at the definition of a vertical query first. It allows you to retrieve the revisions in which an entity instance was created, edited, or deleted. You can create a vertical query by calling the methods createQuery and for revisions of entity of Envers AuditReader. The first parameter defines the entity class for which you want to retrieve the audit information. With the second one, you can specify if you want to retrieve a list of entities which changed at the selected revisions, or if you want to retrieve a list of arrays with an instance of the affected entity, a revision entity, and a revision type enum. This parameter has no effect when you define a projection for your query. Here I set this parameter to true, and the query returns the entities which were active at the selected revisions. The third parameter is called SelectDeletedEntities, and its effect is pretty obvious. When you set it to true, your query will also return the entities that were deleted in a revision. All attributes of a deleted entity, except its ID, are null. You now have an audit query that selects book entities for all revisions which created, updated, or deleted a book entity. I only want to retrieve all versions of one specific book entity. I therefore add an expression that limits the query result to all revisions that affected the book entity with the given ID. As you can see, you can use the audit entity class to reference the audited entity in an expression. It provides you dedicated methods to reference the ID, revision number, and revision type attributes. And you can use the property method to reference all other attributes in a generic way. Let's run this test and see what happens. Here you can see the query that Envers used to retrieve the book entity from the audit log. And here are the two versions of the entity. As you can see here, the second revision changed the title of the book. Let's take a look at another vertical query. This one returns the number of the first revision in which the book entity with the given ID had a given title. As you can see, I set the second parameter to false so that the query returns revision information. And then I call the addProjection method to select the smallest revision number that fulfills the defined criteria. And then I define the where clause. The ID of the audited entity has to be equal to the ID of the entity, and the title has to be Hibernate Tips More Than 70 Solutions to Common Hibernate Problems. And as you can see here, Envers returned the number 3. So in the revision with ID 3, the book had the title Hibernate Tips More Than 70 Solutions to Common Hibernate Problems. Horizontal queries show you the state of your database at a certain time. That means you can select all entities that were active in a given revision and retrieve the attribute values that they had at that point in time. You can define a horizontal query in a similar way as the vertical queries I showed you before. You just need to call the for entities at revision method instead of the for revisions of entity method when you create the audit query. This query selects all book entities in revision 2, which title contained the word hibernate, and returns them in the ascending order of their title. As you can see, you can use the same API to define a vertical and a horizontal query. The audit entity class provides several other methods which allow to define more complex queries. You can, for example, join associated entities and connect multiple expressions as I do in this test case. This audit query returns all book entities in revision 2, which title contained JPA or Hibernate, and which were published by a publisher which name contained the word Manning. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate 5. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!